Welcome back to the episode, last day out of survival. Today we return, boys and girls, and welcome to the full update 1.9. No longer are we in the pre-alpha. This is the full version. It is out on Android, iOS, so should be getting it within the next couple of days. And there are some key differences from the pre-alpha version that we were playing that we are going to go ahead and dive into, talk about those differences before ultimately we're heading out over to the bunker because we have a floppy disk waiting for us. We'll be able to get the red ticket crate popped open, all that jazz, and we'll be able to see a lot of the new items that we can find hopefully throughout there, especially as we kill the blind one. He can apparently drop some new loot too. We have been raided, so we have a revenge raid lined up to wrap all of this up as well. So we got a pretty fantastic day lined up, but let's check it out. So it is official, all dual Berettas have been converted over here to the COLT Python, one of the best revolvers in the world. High accuracy and its smooth triggers are its main advantage. So dual Berettas have now been replaced by the Python. Currently the Python is not modifiable, but I'm guessing that maybe they changed it to this so it'll be modifiable in the future. That would make sense because dual Berettas seem kind of weirder to modify than, you know, a Python. And this is the first revolver to be added into the game, so very cool stuff. It shoots kind of slower, it does kind of sound like the pistol, but it does do 25 damage, so that is cool. I don't know if it has replaced the dual Beretta and it just kind of like everywhere you find the dual Beretta you can find this, or if you might be able to find that in new locations, posiblemente. Another thing that I really love that they changed, check this out, the recyclers cameras now have a shot at getting you lens. Cameras do count as electronics, however, so if you guys have been leveling up electronics like I have, you will be blessed by this news, because of that, we are at the highest chance possible for a lens. It has replaced, what did cameras used to drop? I think they used to drop high-tech high-tech components instead, but now that they're dropping lens, dude, that is pretty freaking dope, because lens is something that is going to be very valuable, especially for some of the things that we're trying to craft up here, specifically for the VSS. I would love to get, ooh, that's kind of cool they changed that to actually have some coloring and whatnot, but this stuff right here, it's gonna take a lot of lens, so hopefully we have some good luck scrapping all of the cameras and whatnot. But check this out as well, the attachment system or whatever was changed. Now you can actually see all of the attachments yourself here. Kind of cool little previews. I think the active skill for this one, I don't even know, this looks like some kind of like weird double sight or something, or I don't even know what these two might be, because we can't really click on them to find out their names or anything, but hopefully we can find them out as they do come. But the shotgun did get a new skin as well in here, and you guys can see some of the mods that it does have available to it. We can see some of the cool mods, and I actually want to scroll through and look at the active mods, because mods like this, any of the ones with stars, have an active skill. Currently, active skills are not in 1.9. They are going to be coming in a future update, but we only have one weapon with an active skill. That is the bow. The way that it should work is that it will add a skill in the active tab that we can use whenever we want. I'm guessing, I have no clue what the bow's active skill could be for having a laser sight. Maybe a guaranteed headshot? I'd happily take that, TBH, because you could line it up pretty. But anyways, the Kalashnikov is some pretty interesting stuff here into the form of a freaking bayonet and a undermounted grenade launcher. So I think those two are pretty self-explanatory. This will give you a melee attack. This will give you the ability to shoot a grenade launcher. That'll be very handy for actually taking on the witch if you can shoot a grenade launcher while still using your AK. The VSS's special things over here is actually another one of these, which kind of sucks. We've already started investing like crazy into the Itpial, which is still a good investment. This thing does some really nice boosts, but this is going to be some kind of special ability that we can gain. And then the bipod as well is going to have an active skill that we can add. I'm guessing the bipods will let you stand still and have a lot better accuracy for the scar. It doesn't have an undermounted grenade launcher. It has kind of similar to the VSS with just a blue colored light. I seriously can't tell what that is. Also a bipod M16 we are seeing. It has couple of very special scopes. Those are going to be the special things that that gets. God knows what that is. That looks like some sort of weird attachment that makes that, who even knows. And well, lads and lassies, I think we've been bamboozled. I think since the pre-alpha, the laser sight actually changed. This is not, oh man, that actually sucks because we sunk freaking materials and stuff in this, but the laser sight does not come with an active skill by the looks of it. It has changed to that bowstring over there, so kind of sucks for us, but that is why we're playing the pre-alpha. It was not ready to be sent out to everybody, and a lot of those things were still subject to change and whatnot. So here what we got as well is gonna be, I'm guessing we might be able to like throw the spears. That just looks like it'll be kind of powerful. And then anything special for this? Oh my god, I want, oh, that's like a motor, dude. What if we can, oh my god, I feel like that's gonna be like a freaking chainsaw version of the saw blitz. That's looking nutty. But anyways, I didn't want to look over that a little bit, talk about that for a sec. There are new recipes as well. Boom, what you guys are seeing here is going to be the new recipe for the workbench. Has gotten a lot cheaper and it is a lot lower level to craft now, so it's a lot more accessible to everybody. And boom, sector 7 has become cheaper to get into as well. So fed freaking fantastic stuff all around. And you know what else is pretty cool? On the second floor of the bunker, you can actually find another modification desk or whatever. It is the desk that belongs to the specialist. So I'm just gonna go over here and grab some things as well so we can open up every single bunker crate and see if maybe those will have some goodies for us. But that hurts. It seriously hurts that I thought we seriously crafted the thing that gives us the active skills. So possiblemente, maybe active skills are in the game and we just haven't happened to got them. Or at least from what I have heard, again, if they aren't in the game now, it is definitely something that hopefully we'll be seeing in the next couple of updates. And the bunker code for today is going to be the magical sequence of numbers known as 27406. That is going to be the numbers to get y'all and get us into the bunker for the shenanigans we're about to dive into. Go ahead and get all the openings. Going to put this new cult of Python to use and see exactly how that can go. But that is going to be a sequence of numbers, at least by the time that I am putting in. If that is out of date, and also check this out. These guys have a quest for C4 and a blind one. I think our floppy disk and killing of the blind one here in hard mode will perfectly make those raiders very happy and make us have some great progress towards another quest. But back to what I was saying, if that is out of date by the time you guys use it, hopefully so. But fan freaking fantastic person has put an up-to-date code in that comment section down below. And if they haven't, perhaps you guys could be the fan freaking fantastic person that does add that updated code to the comments to help out every wonderful person in this absolutely fan freaking fantastic community that we are rocking out here. But anyways, I'm just ready to rock this Python a little bit. I want to see, like, it does, what, 25 damage? So I mean, for any enemy that has like 100 health or any multiple of 25, it's gonna be pretty nice. It's gonna suck for the 80 health enemies, but maybe when we can mod it, like if we even add a little bit of damage to it, it will get a lot better. But I'm very intrigued to see how useful it'll be, because it does have a lot lower of a fire rate, if you guys noticed. 1.4. They really gave it a solid nerf compared to your run-of-the-mill pistol. I don't remember off the top of my head what the pistola thing is, but we should be able to loot a pistol here in one of these crates that we're about to open. So we'll find out and we can compare in just a gif. But I'd love to hear from you guys in that comment section down below what you are thinking of the 1.9 update as you are diving into it, along with some of these kind of like small changes compared to the pre-alpha that we're seeing now, and your guys' thoughts on those. I know my thoughts are that it hurts that the laser sight ain't as good as I thought it was, because the bow, I mean, we could try using the bow a little bit now. Maybe it was glitched before, and we'll see if the laser sight actually helps out anything. But it's got some pretty nice range here. Kobe! All right, totally missed that. Look at that fast biter. Didn't see. Boop! There we go. Got him for a solid 17. I just want to see if we can maybe get this guy on, like, you know, a critical damage or something, because I don't think I've ever gotten a critical hit with one of these bows yet, which is kind of annoying, because this laser sight seriously doesn't seem to have boosted up the bow that much. I originally got it only because I thought it had the active skill, but it doesn't anymore. So again, bwah, bwah. But that's besides the point. We got the COLT Python, and hello, Mr. Zombies. You must go today before you get any hits off on your boy Papa Star. But I'd love to hear what you guys think about any of these changes in 1.9 for yourselves, if you guys have gotten your hands on it, if you're on iOS. Like I said, hopefully it will be coming within the next couple of days. That is usually how it does come, and I believe they said the same thing in their update vlog thingy mabob that it should be coming soon. But let me know what you guys think in that comment section down below. And by the comments, put your third of the way into the week, $25 iTunes Play Store gift card giveaway. All you gotta do is always make sure the like button, make sure to subscribe, that'll cheer you on today's video. Y'all can go ahead and try it every single last Earth video when Saturday rolls around, aka tomorrow. This is gonna be the last day y'all can enter it. Feel free to enter it on older videos as well. But tomorrow we're gonna be picking the winner of this past week's $25 iTunes Play Store gift card giveaway, and we're gonna be kicking off a brand new giveaway that exact same day as well. So make sure you lads and lassies stay tuned. And we're getting some okay stuff. Could be better, could be worse. It's the red crate that has me intrigued, and I'm hoping we can come across some kind of valuable stuff over in these crates as well. But definitely go ahead and do that. Next Saturday, we're going to be kicking off a new weekly giveaway as well, which is tomorrow. So that's going to be a fresh giveaway y'all can go ahead and enter in on. So make sure notification bell is a hit as well after you do subscribe. Make sure you can stay up to date with this series. Make sure you get notified of, because YouTube is absolutely awful with telling people that, hey, a video's live unless you hit that bell. Even with the bell hit, man, YouTube can be kind of poopy. But what we... Oh, let's go, baby! That's another lens! I really, really need lens. So bless up, lens are confirmed. We can get them out of red ticket crates. We got another C4 in addition to the one at base. The floppy disk we're about to get will hopefully help us out a lot. We got some fan-freaking-tastic SWAT armor. We got all of this stuff over here. I kind of want to make a pit stop over to the second... I kind of want to go to the second floor and show off that bench that I was talking about. Some of these things that come modded as well. A green laser and a green laser on that one. So is the green laser kind of just like default or something? I don't know, but that's all right. We can save the shotgun over a little bit later. Ooh, our modded shotgun has a higher fire rate than the normal shotgun too. Interesting to note, but we're going to go ahead and start equipping some of these guns. We're going to go ahead and get to chow down on this. We got to go and activate hard mode as well. But yeah, make sure notification bell is so you guys can stay up to date. Never miss a video, that type of jazz, so y'all can know when the latest Last Day on Earth updates do come out. Latest of gameplay like we are diving into today. Latest of information as soon as it does come out as well. And of course, other dope survival games all throughout. So it's a pretty worthy, pretty solid investment. I tell you what, just like the hard mode and the floppy disk we're about to get, and hopefully we get multiple lens from the floppy disk, because then we could craft that ridiculously amazing sight for the VSS. I really want my VSS to be juiced, guys, because I clicked on three, dude. What? Okay, whatever. Slight detour. We gotta go down to floor four first before we go to floor three, but that should be too big of a deal. All right, there we go. Elevator. Let's head out back to three. We just gotta kill a blind one. That should give us more than enough hard mode items to get the floppy disk. And then from there, I wanna go ahead and dive into a raid. 1.9 launched today, so we're trying to do absolutely as much as possible. And hopefully we can. Oh, I was supposed to put this to the. We'll do that back topside whenever we go. For now, we must continue going forward. And as we do, we must prepare for the inevitable boom shagalaga python to you, my friend. A little bit of turn and burn tactics here because, well, it is a good gun, don't get me wrong, but could be better. Could definitely be better because it's just slow. And to be fair, we are doing hard mode too, but the good news is pretty easy to outrun your enemies. I'm gonna use the rest of this python here. I want to use the new gun, man. 1.9 came out. This gun actually has a description. It was in the pre-alpha. It was kind of glitched where it didn't have a name or a description. Again, that's part of the reason why I got the pre-alpha early, because it wasn't the full alpha. The update wasn't ready. Now it is. All of us do have it. As you guys can see, there's a lot more that has come along with it as well, which is awesome news because there's a lot more that even I wasn't having. So I'm more than excited to dive into this. And why aren't you people dropping hard mode items? This is not at all the deal. I don't like this. We should whip out Monsieur Scar over here with all of the marvelous mods we invested into. Yeah. The long barrel, extended mag, and laser should do for a pretty damaging the type of combo. We just got to watch out because he can start missing after a while. I saw someone saying that the missing was OP because I was shooting a lot, like until it missed, then I moved a little, and then I shot and it was missing a lot again. But that's the thing. The game still knows that you were just firing your gun for a really long time, even right after like you stop, right? So like you can't just like fire for like 10 seconds, move a smidge, and then start firing again. At least I don't think so. It's not the most effective thing in the world. Like your guy actually has to like, you know, calm down from the recoil, since recoil IRL, dude, that stuff can destroy shoulders, all right? It ain't no joke. Recoil's cray cray. Why don't we whip out the Magnum for taking out some of these guys with, at least until it breaks, because this is a perfect type of predicament to use it upon, and hopefully a predicament that has led into some personal effects. I will take that to the bank, but also I do want to kind of blow through some of our weapons that just have lower durability so we can unlock some more slots for, our stuff, because I need slots for stuff. You know what I can do? Why don't we go ahead, do a little bit of that, and I'll start feasting on the beans whenever necessary, because we still need one more, slot to open up. One will be for the hard mode items. Because we still need two other hard mode items. Dog tags and the personal effects. And maybe the big one bone from our compadre as well. Let's go out over to the Scar, though, for taking out Mr. Turd over here. Just gotta watch out. Don't want to extend the fire too much. Gotta let it calm down for a sec. And all in all, bada bing, bada boom, down goes the turd. I think a bit... Ooh, heat sensor. Can we scrap these down? I don't know, but I haven't got a heat sensor in a while, so I definitely got to pick that up. So we definitely need more room as well. Apparently, these chests over here can have glue, and I don't know if they can have lenses, but they can have glue from what I've heard. Currently, we have not gotten that, but we are getting gun oil, another important thing for this update, so I'm more than happy to be doing that. I'm also more than happy to swap this around a little bit. I don't think any of my guns, yeah, they can't reach that guy over there, so that's kind of poopy. I'm getting a little bit thirsty, so I'm just gonna eat beans until I'm not thirsty, because that's what any sensible person would do, if you ask me. I don't know about you. We'll start picking up some of that gun oil for the road back home and start dealing with some of the toxic spitters that have yet to feel the wrath of shotgun rain. Keep running, baby. Well, I mean, we don't really have a shotgun rain with us at the moment. Please leave a message after the beep, but you get the message, just like these toxic spitters are starting to get the message when the scar starts shooting. And dude, the fact that we can mod the scar now is one of the best parts of this update, because the scar in every way, shape, and form is better than the 8K, besides the fact the AK has a fifth slot it can use. But the scar, I mean, its base damage is 18 compared to the AK's 15, compared to the M16's 12. Fully modded AK used to do 18 damage, so it was just as good as a scar. But now that we can mod the scar, once we get some good mods for this thing, man, I'm telling you, it's gonna get spooky. I'm excited. Here's the bow as well. I think we might try and use the rest of this. Actually, the bow doesn't have really good range. We should be able to. Oh, not that good, apparently. Ain't that just great? Alright then, no bow. Instead, we'll go with Python number 2, because I still got a good amount of these back at home, and it's new in the 1.9 update, so all in all, seems like a pretty good thing to be utilizing, if you ask me. Then we can save some of the better things, like our scar, for when the, oh my god, I forgot there was a third one. But then we can save our scar for the blind one himself, since we can't use no more full auto shotgun, which is... Ah, it's sad that there's not going to be any more shotgun storm, but nonetheless, we should still be able to take him out. No worries at all, but it's just not going to be as easy as it was during that stretch of time where the shotgun was fully automatic. Dear God, was that a beautiful stretch of history. I think I speak for all of us when I put that out there. Okie dokie, the door should be open, and question is, how do we want to take this? Great question. How do we want to take this? Well, we do have that thing's about to break, though. We got the shotgun. That's not as great. I wish I had some AK mods. For now, it's looking like our best bet might be just equipping... I think these two right there, honestly. And then maybe once he charges into a wall, once that thing breaks, we'll swap out the AK. But all in all, let's get it, fam! Let's not get it yet. Let's eat some jerky. Big app to full health. And let's not get it yet. We gotta activate this terminal with our super elite hacking abilities. And now, as I was trying to say futilely for the last couple of times, let's get it. Hello, blind one. How do you do? I hear that you can drop a new type of loot. Color me intrigued. I hope that you drop some big bones for me. I also hope that you don't hurt me too much. Please, why are you going that way? I don't like that way. Yes, yes, yes. Please go over there so I can bow into you with a little bit of the scar. Our problem is we might need to move around a little bit. We gotta take into account that this stuff can miss now, which honestly makes me kind of want to bring back the semi-auto guns a little bit more. You know what I mean? Like, the scar's all nice and dandy, don't get me wrong, but having to do damage like this, having to worry about misses every once in a while, it starts incorporating some strategy into these fights. That's some stuff we're not used to, man. It's some stuff that's gonna end up in us getting wailed upon a little bit harder than we're used to. At least we know how to handle the big one. That's not the worry at all. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do as well. This thing's not... Okay, I was waiting on it to break. Never mind. Well, now it broke, so that's just great. Okay, I'm gonna take this opportunity, run up against this wall. He can't kill me, that's the good news. And then this is the great opportunity to maybe... I'm saving that shotgun, dude. I wanna fully... All shotguns, because we have crafted the silencer for shotguns. All shotguns are now exclusively on raiding duty, pretty much. Oh my god, these misses are bad. And see, those are the misses you gotta take into account, because if you just keep shooting that extended fire, it does not get bueno. And to be fair, I think the AK isn't the most forgiving. I think the AK's stability isn't good, since the AK IRL, I think it's known for having some pretty solid recoil too, so I could see it. But I mean, one extent, like, we're able to do about 100 damage with the AK. We're definitely doing way better with the scar. I think part of it was that the scar took longer to get inaccurate, though. But all right, blind one, back into the wall you go. And I seriously do not remember spending this long on the blind one in a minute, but I do remember he's about to do that. And no soup for you, blind one. No soup. No soup, I say. I'm so sorry, but no soup today. All right, the only soup is for me, and I'm not even gonna eat it. I'm just gonna let it sit there. That's how evil I am. Just kidding, guys. I'm not actually that evil, I swear. Oh no, he's charging into that wall. Kabuya! Let's get some shots off on him. I wonder if even if I swap guns, it still works that way. Ooh. You know what? I think that makes the best strategy. I think semi-automatic guns. You probably want one full auto gun and one semi-automatic gun for every situation. that appears like it's gonna be your best bet. For now, oh man, there we go. Let's let that cool down for a sec. Dude, looks like we can, dang man, the blind one is seriously a toughie out here. All right, we're doing about 100 damage here though. I'll let him charge on this wall one more time. There you go, go ahead, get that charge off, and then hopefully I can get some good Kalashnikov rounds on you. I think if you move before the misses start happening too hard, it kind of buffs out. There we go, he's down below 100. This is it, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. After you charge, watch, he's gonna glitch through the wall. Don't glitch through the wall, baby. Charge through that wall, and please tell me that this AK is accurate enough to finish the job. Let's go, baby. Big bones, abnormally big bones extracted from a zombie body. These can be found through all of the bosses, and also frenzied giants have a chance of dropping them from what I have heard. Let's hit take all on that puppy. Let's leave this. We could scrap it though too for loot. I don't know what to do. You know, I'm gonna eat the rest of my jerky, so be it. It wasn't that much jerky. I am definitely collecting the big bones from that, and we should have a recipe for the success of me when it comes to opening up the floppy disk. We just gotta run back to Mr. Guy person, specialist, that's his name, and take care of that. But yeah, it's gonna be very interesting, because now we gotta start thinking of, ow, why'd that hurt me? Why was that so delayed? Now we gotta start thinking of how we actually wanna go about building our guns, because like a gun like the AKs you guys have seen doesn't stay accurate for long, but if we toss the right attachments on it, it will stay accurate, and it hopefully will stay for long. I think especially if one of the things we could do, the speed, I think if we bring the speed down a notch with, actually if you put some of the higher magnification sights, they bring down the speed. I'm probably gonna do that with the VSS, but I think the lower the speed, the more accurate it is as well. Because like the AK is a high fire rate, you guys saw how that was treating us. But anyways, that's besides the point. The point is this helmet better than our, yeah, we took some damage, took a wailing from that, baby. We also, they definitely took some of these from us, so I'm gonna go about restocking that really quickly, because, yeah, we should be able to pick up a couple from each. Honestly, this one doesn't give us one, but all in all, taking into account the ones we got from these, we only used up 3 medkits on the blind one. All in all, okay deal? Maybe? I don't know. Anyways, what was I gonna pick back up? I think it was these that I was looking to. Ooh, we could get the car air filter. Ah, there's just so much valuables. I think we're gonna have to come back here. And I definitely do want to come back here as well to check out that workbench on the second floor. I think we'll do that next time though, because for now, like I said, I want to get this floppy disk. I want to talk to you. I definitely want to turn that in. And with that turned in, we are ridiculously close to getting another one of those. One day, baby. One day that'll happen, but we do have these big bones acquired, and I've never been this excited for big bones in my life. But there's a first for everything, and I want to see what they can bring us. And I also want to see what this floppy disk can bring us as well. Let's go ahead, sauce that pup into that. That will upload. We'll have the coordinates. We got to go get the rest of the, I mean, our inventory's got a couple more slots, so we're going to keep grabbing stuff from here. And with a good amount of the valuable stuff grabbed, I do believe it is time for us to make our exit. And before we go into the floppy disk location, we do need to, what's the other thing? What is the other thing we must do? I can't think of it for the life of me. Oh yeah, we gotta drop all the stuff off at home. Then we get the floppy disk, and then we go on the raid, and we'll have a fair amount of C4 at our disposal. Hopefully the raids treat us well, but we know how that's been going for us. I'm gonna go ahead, drive on home, put the stuff away, and we will be heading on over to the location that just popped up on our map. Not that one, this one. Ooh, it's actually gonna be kind of within the area of the raid too, so it's not gonna be that far, so we'll be able to save energy. We would save more energy if we could go there first, but that's not happening with this inventory setup. But talk to y'all in a sec. And with a lot of this stuff put away, we over here, this is the new shotgun we got. Then we are about to pimp out to be a hell of a lot better. But we do have these big bones as well. We don't have any recipes that currently require them, but nonetheless, they are a pretty rare occurrence by the looks of it, probably more so for the melee side of modding. So it's definitely something that I want to put away over into the safety of, don't really have room in there, but there's definitely room in there for us to put some stuff away. And I'm gonna put this to C4 away for now since we are going to the floppy disk location first. We do need to swap out. We'll use these guns to finish rapid, or to actually go to the floppy disk location and enjoy that. But this fully modded, not this fully modded shotgun, but this fully durable shotgun is about to be modded, and we are about to make it magnificent. Bada bing, up goes speed, up goes durability, up goes damage. Go over here, bada boom, some more damage, less noise. Oh no, it only brings noise down by half though. Aye, ain't that unfortunate. Maybe the big ammo does, no, the big ammo doesn't bring up noise. So it looks like the shotgun unfortunately cannot be fully silenced, but it can be silenced a lot. I guess that does kind of make sense though, since shotguns, I don't think you can fully silence a shotgun IRL, but you kind of can see it kills the range and it does bring the weight up a lot. Oh, that's probably why we were so slow at times, but it can shoot a little bit faster, a little bit more crit damage. Like, it actually does have a lot of great benefits, but hopefully we can get some more mods to hopefully kind of counterbalance some of this. Maybe a mod that brings the noise all the way down, but nonetheless, it's a good thing to be rolling around with. So that was a common misconception I saw before during the update. It did show, or during the pre-alpha, it did show that the shotgun should not have been making any noise, but I think that was glitched just because the shotgun's such a powerful tool that we gotta go and get some water too. But I think that was glitched, because if you do have the right modded weapon, if in the stats it doesn't make any noise, it shouldn't make any noise on the raid. I think the stats were just glitched for the shotgun. And we gotta pee, don't we? Yes, we do. But I think the stats were just glitched for the shotgun, because I remember it showed that it made no noise in like the noise bar and the gunsmith bench, but now it's showing that it only cuts it down by half. So what probably happened was the silencer was just kind of being universally, it was silencing everything or something. But silenced weapons, if it is fully silenced, it should still not be making noise during raids. That was a glitch from what I heard. This is something that the devs, I believe, fixed in time for 1.9 to come out for all. Again, that's another reason that it was a pre-alpha that I was hopping into, because glitches like that were in the game. Detrimental glitches that could have absolutely ruined some of your guys' raids and stuff. That's why the update was not quite ready. But again, I was more than happy to bite the bullet to get to show it off a little bit for you guys. And just huge thanks again to Kafir for giving me such an awesome opportunity to check it out early like that, especially for all of you fat-freaking-tastic boys and the girls. But to the floppy disk location we go. And with it, hopefully multiple C4. I swear, if this is an infected box, I'm gonna be such a sad camper. Don't infected box me, Gabe. Just give me the C4 flat out. I ain't trying to play no games, all right? The only games I'm playing are the games of death and destruction upon toxic abominations and stuff. Oh no, I'm missing. All right, we gotta let this cool down a little bit. Now, down you go. So I'm sure as well as more of us do play this and whatnot, let's go, baby. It's a normal one. That's what I wanted. But as more of us do play this as well, okay, I kind of want to, I won't chop down that tree. But as more of us do play this as well, I do imagine as a community, we will figure out exactly how the recoil system works, how long you gotta wait until it resets, depending on how long you fire, that type of stuff. And let's go. That's right, blue. Oh, and we, oh, floppiness can become better. I think it goes without saying. We got a full set of I think that changed. Wasn't that a thing where the floppy disk used to only give you one piece of armor? So I think that's new. We've gotten freaking recipes here. I was hoping it'd be better than, well, these recipes, but so be it. Beggars can't be choosers. We got some more C4. Oh yeah, baby. We got some more of that. And we are kind of by the bunker, so maybe I'll go turn that in and grab myself another one. But we're getting a ton of good stuff. Another Kalashnikov and multiple C4. That brings our C4 total up to 4, man. We're doing, today's a good day. The red crate gave us it. The floppy disk gave us it. All in all, it's been a good one. And we got another lens, bringing our lens total up to 7 cameras now. So the puppy, we got another puppy. But whatchamacallit, the camera now is super valuable. So especially if I find a camera out in the wild, I'm taking that puppy back home, because lens are probably the most key thing that I'm missing. And they are gonna be very, very key in producing scopes. And I think every scope requires at least one lens. So for a weapon attachment, like literally one of the weapon attachments needs lens, like one of those slots pretty much, since every sight does, except maybe like if you have like a custom iron sight, that might be a thing for a couple guns. I'm not entirely sure. What I am sure, we're circling back here and dive into down here so we can give this last blueprint. And the reason I really want to do this is because we were 5% away from getting another blueprint. So it's a great opportunity for us, because I ain't trying to wait till next time. Oh, I already killed that zombie. Okay, I was gonna say I had to murder a zombie first, but with this being a duplicate, we can toss it into there. We can take that, and if all goes well, We got a saw blade blueprint that we also already know, so we can toss that back into that cycle as well. But okay, I'm gonna head home. We gotta drop off the rest of these goodies, and we gotta prepare for a raid. And let's just go ahead and put away the rest of this. Over here, we have yet another lens to be added to the mix. Like I said, the cameras are recycling. Hopefully those end up treating us well. The steel plates can keep her going. And we do. We finally have a full set of SWAT. That's so nice that floppy disks now do drop a full set of SWAT armor, because they used to only drop one piece, which was really weird, because you literally got better stuff from, the ticket crates themselves, because they would actually give you full sets. But now the floppy disk is giving us a full set, and we got some pretty nice stuff all in all. We also got the puppy. Hello, Heidi. We're going to get over to the dog crate. I promise I will feed you eventually. I'm a good owner. Don't try to say otherwise. But let's go ahead and put the last of the paint. Never mind. We can't put our paint away in there. Let's put the last of our white paint over there for safekeeping. And we also got another 20 stack of cameras over there I'm trying to keep safe for in the future when we do decide to scrap them down a little bit. I think our first camera should be done scrapping, so woo! Got some plastic. Let's produce some more lens, baby, because I want to make a god VSS, and that will happen with the getting a very, very nice sight on it. And with some of these getting picked up for all our troubles as well, we should be able to grab a couple iron hatchets from our inbox as well. Worst case, since we do still have like 2 or 3 left over from our chase of C4 that I just never want to bring up again. But before we leave, I definitely wanted to make sure that we reinforce a couple of things of what we got here, especially because there used to be a doorway here and it actually broke, which is kind of spooking me for some reason. So I'm going to toss a couple doorways up in there, hopefully in case someone comes, I don't know, just to protect ourselves or something like that. And then deck the rest of this place out with halls of jolly. Just kidding, it's not Christmas. Decking it out with some more level 1 things to give us that protection that we also need. And bada bing, we should be running out of wood soon, I feel like. But if not, when in Rome, when building a giant wooden base, let's build it to the best we can. And there you have it, a little bit more protection up on the outside. I didn't finish putting the door there, so that's great. Kind of finessed myself there. But one more thing I want to do before we head out, get some food. There we go, with our daily little dose of food and also a little chug of water. We can go ahead and toss those for the time being. What I did want to do though is actually test out that whole like noise thing, because we do have the silencer unlocked for the pistol as well. As you guys can see, it is at full noise. Equipping the silencer for the pistol, on the other hand, does completely cancel noise. So I'm going to be bringing the pistol along as well, just so we can double check that that is how it works. We might try to get a cool sight on our pistol too, but we do have some pretty nice attachments all in all. Oh no! So apparently that right there will completely kill our noise. It doesn't matter if we have a silencer on it. That shutterstock just destroys any chance with the silencer actually keeping things silenced. Is that what it's called, a shutterstock? So we do need to keep that off, but that's an interesting thing you gotta keep in mind, is that these mods kinda, you know, they can cancel out each other's effects, and you gotta be careful with that. And I'm kinda bummed that I invested in this now, because dang, man, that plus to the noise is very, very detrimental. I wonder if maybe this extremely rare one doesn't add to the noise. Maybe another one of these will actually be kind to us. This one actually looks really cool. It's got like a copper color or something like that. Hopefully we'll come across it, but it's extremely rare. So we're gonna have to just cross our fingers and whatnot for that. But all in all, our inventory is looking as prepared as can be for the shenanigans we are going to go ahead and dive on into. Without further ado, our shotguns are decked out, our pistol is decked out, and I am decked out with some hype. And I imagine the person we're about to raid is not decked out with hype. All right, Avatar Man, Avatar Edition. I don't know, it says Avatar and then Add, so I guess this guy's probably studying for a math test. I hope that by me raiding your base, you decide to calm down from Last Day on Earth for a couple hours and get that studying in. I want you to get that A, Avatar. But I also want you to give me the best loot imaginable from this raid. So I see, as you can see, we've come to a bit of a crossroads. It does not look like he has a chopper in his possession, so that's never a great sign. But golly, is that shotgun looking nice. And seriously, I love that the shotgun does have a new skin. And oh no, I do not love... I just don't know if it's worth to break into that, man. I don't. So you know what I'm going to do first? Here's what I'm going to do for... We did just get some... Okay, here's what I'm gonna do, because I'm a little bit skeptical. I'm gonna break through some of his outdoor chests. We're gonna see if we get something valuable from his outdoor chest first. Oh, dear. Okay, good. We put the C4 away. We're gonna see if maybe... they're looking empty. All right, never mind. Done with it. We got 4 C4. I don't mind breaking down this freaking door. All right, because maybe there'll be good stuff within, or maybe raids will just keep on doing the raid thing. But you know what? No, this is going to be a high explosive episode. 1.9 launch today. If there's ever a day that I question raiding, today should it be the day. Today's the day we make this as bombastic of an episode as possible. Mr. Bombastic. Good morning, my friend. I am very happy I decided to do things this way, and God, do I love the shotgun, not against the fast biters, though, so I'm gonna put the pistol over, over that way. Let's swap over to the pistol so we can go and, oh, that's a critical. I love watching this thing do critical damage, and boop, there we go. Finish you off really quickly. I can't full auto with this either, which is a bummer, but I can get criticals, and criticals are very, very juicy, but all right. And then we can use the shotgun for the big guys over here because it, like, look at this. It's barely, oh my God, nice front flip. You guys can see it's barely adding noise. Just now, it finally went up by one. So that's not really a big worry. My only worry is this man has a lot of chests and, oh, he's got a recycler too he could break into. Please, do you have a lot of phones or something? No, oh, he colored one of his chests, man. I have high hopes. This man, maybe he's not the best looter in the world, but God dang it, he's an artist. What is this? A modified AK-47. Interesting. Okay, so I think what this is, first off, let's react to the fact, this guy's got a lot of guns, thank you kindly. I was just kind of drawn away by the white box that we got here. You know what I think that is? I think, this is something Kafir's gonna have to address, because the bases here still have all the items from, 1.8.6, because that's the last time they did a raid update. Whenever they update the raid, that's when they update the database, right? The database of possible bases to raid, meaning we might still come across weapon parts, and here we have come across a modified AK-47. I'm scared to equip that, so I'm just gonna leave that white box in there. But I think Kafir, maybe they'll try and set out like a patch or something that fixes that, because that should be an AK with all the slot system, but it doesn't have anything, which is, I mean, an interesting way. Ooh, thank you kindly for the electronic circuit. Ordinarily, we got some takers coming this way. Oh, we got a lot of takers. All right, let's go. Just kind of pop you boys over there in the faces with these silenced pistola bullets. Bada bing, bada boom to all of you guys. We got to deal with the toxic abominations in a sec. We'll do that. I know that I shouldn't be using... here's the thing, dude. It sucks to use the shotgun, but the shotgun doesn't add that much noise, so it's not a huge deal. Boop. Oh, a beautiful 36, but... You know what? Yeah, why don't we try to, I don't know, we could try to shoot the pistol a whole ton. It does do a good amount of damage, all in all. Let's just try and back up so we're not getting wailed on by 50 people, because I do want to keep my armor quality good. I'm going to use this pistol the most I can. The shotgun's nice, but this raid has a chance. I want to break as many chests as possible for this raid. I mean, to be fair, if it comes to it, I'm more than happy. I'm more than open to using my shotgun, right? But I'm just trying to keep it silenced. All right, this is taking too long. Shotgun raid. Oh, well, there goes the shotgun. All right, that was a short-lived shotgun raid. But we had some for a while. But this guy, here's the thing about this guy's base, too, that I maybe should have taken as context clues. He does have multiple iron benches. He does have the recycler. He's a little bit further along than some of the, like, little 3x3 stone bases we find. So that's usually a good... I like to use that as a good measure, see if they have a chopper, what benches they have that kind of give you a good idea of how far into the game they are. And then from there, you can hopefully make a kind of judgment call if it's worth going after, you know, especially if your C4 is up to stake. But dude, we're coming home with a pretty big army. I was gonna say this is a revenge raid, but then I'm like, wait a minute, because, well, they didn't actually take anything that valuable this time. So this is mainly loot that we're getting here, and I'm a fan of it. That's okay. It's nice armor and stuff, but if we can start getting raids like this again, I could even be a bit more complex, but loots like this, I will take, especially the mysterious white box loot that I don't know, man. We have a limited edition collectible, a fully modded AK that isn't under like the new system or something, and not as much dope stuff as I thought. I guess I'll just take those two cameras. I kind of left those behind because I thought, at least from the chest we broke open first, my hopes were high. My hopes have gotten significantly lower. But let's continue on with the raid. We got three more chests to go. So all in all, I think we're okay saving this thing for later. Although, kid, check it out, dude. All four of these pistols we just got, all of these are about to become silenced pistols. That is the magic of this update. Once you unlock us, like, especially an attachment like the silencer, once you unlock that, dude, literally all of these pistols, these aren't just normal pistols in my eyes. These are modded pistols with these two mods specifically. I can toss those on. Maybe make them less silenced, or maybe I'll put on the comfortable grip or whatever, and they won't be silenced anyway, but they'll do cool damage, because honestly, the silencer attachment does buff the stats pretty freaking well all around. It's just like a good attachment to look into. But let's try and maybe use the rest of the pistol on the little schmucks that are going to be coming after us. And then we can use the shotgun for the cleanup crew. Because we are one chest away from the next wave coming and trying to eat all of our faces. Oh, we had some cop over there too. All right, I'm coming. Oh, don't corner me in here, buddy. Don't corner. Okay, some of you guys got to go. Some of you guys got to go. All right, now I got to do the loop-to-loop. Get out of there. Not trying to get trapped with all of you. Don't worry. You guys seem like a ton of fun. I'd love to have a party with y'all at some point. Today is not that day. I'm very sorry. I'm currently being swarmed by a lot of things. So, yeah. Oh, no. My armor is getting close to being broken. No. Don't break the armor. My armor's so nice. It's so nice. Oh, fast biter. There you go. We should be able to outrun. Why do I feel so slow? Oh, you know what it is? I think having silenced weapons out does affect your speed. I think the silencer adds a good amount of weight. And you know what else adds a good amount of weight onto your mind? Shot a gun. Hold that then. Shoot as fat. A gun. Gotta wait for it. Just gotta circle back. Rain, baby! That does a whole ton of good, and boop to you too. Silent shotgun raid is the greatest thing to ever happen to Last Day on Earth, and yeah, that's all I'm- Oh, hold on, is this one? Oh, I don't think this one has a silencer. What, in Tarnation? Was that one not? Oh no! I never put it on, I don't think! I got distracted! Ah! That's not good! I thought for sure that one had a silencer. I guess I'm going crazy, or is this the shotgun that we picked up? Oh, that's why. Oh man. Oh, we really played ourselves there. All right, well, that probably added way more noise than it should have, and I knew it was only doing 70 damage, and it sounded too loud. I'm like, what is happening? Shotgun rain is happening, but that's bad. It added more noise, but doesn't matter too much. So, oh, and that shotgun that we got from this raid as well, that's gonna be a silent shotgun as well, so... Like I'm saying, 1.9, I've seen some people hating on it. Here's the thing, these attachments, they're not a one-time thing. They're an investment, because look at exactly what's happening to me. It might take a while to fully craft the attachment, right? But once it is crafted, you can get into a situation like this, where every time you find, like, a bland pistol, no longer is it a bland pistol. Every time you find a bland shotgun, no longer is it a bland shotgun. Like, look at this, we've added 7 damage to our shotgun and 0.1 speed, and it barely makes any noise. Still makes a little bit, but nonetheless, our Glock over here, it shoots slightly faster. It doesn't do more damage, which is a bummer, but maybe if we get a right sight on it, that might happen. But nonetheless, I don't know, man. Attachment system is definitely promising, and I am liking what I'm seeing. Hopefully they incorporate those active skills though, when we do get some cool stuff popping off with that. But we got to be chasing some more of those extremely rare recipes, which will definitely be a doozy. Okie dokie, hunky dory. I don't really know what else I want to grab from here. Ooh, I'm actually gonna be grabbing some saw blade maces. You know why? These are something we have to invest into the gunsmith bench for saw blade mace attachments, specifically the Diablo attachment, and maybe the electric attachment too. If we could get that saw blade like electric motor going, dude, that looks freaking nutty. But I'm gonna go ahead and start putting actually this is a revenge raid, it doesn't matter what we put away, but I'm gonna start putting some of those things away, freeing up a couple slots. We'll grab the rest of the saw blade mace, and I don't know what else exactly. Thinking. I did grab a stack of beans. I know, listen, my bean supply is going low. I still got other types of meats, but beans are a very fine type of meat that I would like to stick around. You know what I mean? Yeah, I don't know. Looking at this screen, maybe. Ah, batteries just, they have a pretty good shot at copper, though, so never mind. They're good. Those give us electronic circuits. Those are good. Anything else we maybe want to reconsider with? Actually, this thing right here, very good now. You know why? This is actually used in a lot of these, a lot of the saw blade mace upgrades. So honestly, I will be picking that up. I have so many of those springs at home. I value the saw blade more because I have not valued the saw blade for so long. I'm pretty sure we don't have a lot at home because I always assumed it was for the zombie truck, and I don't know, the zombie truck probably isn't coming for a while, so I just kind of never stockpiled, but yet here we are, now, in need form, meaning even if something seems like it's going to be for one thing, and that one thing seems very far away, you never know, man, it could change what it is used for, but with, ooh, that's like right here, man, six energy to run over, I have to, there's a chance of a blueprint from an airdrop, and I think that's exactly a type of chance I gotta explore, because I'm over here on the blueprint hunt. Especially some of those more rare ones. I am definitely in need of those. Hello, Mr. Speedhair. No. Sit down, broski. I don't really know. I guess we'll use this. I'm not trying to use any of my... Oh, no.
I'm not trying to use any of my pistols since all of those are now silenced pistols when you think about it. Plus use the M16. Don't have any good attachments for it, and it is the worst rifle out of the three, so I'm kind of just trying to focus on modifying the SCAR to the best of its ability. Make that as dope as can be. I don't think the SCAR can get the like underhand grenade launcher though. That thing looks nutty. And speaking of nutty, we didn't get anything too nutty from that. But this is going to start right off for this episode of Last Day on Earth Survival. Hope that you guys did enjoy. I'm just going to go home, continue the recycler grind and whatnot. Next time we will return. We'll go through some more of the bunker as well. Try to have some shenanigans over there. Do some more raids as per usual. And of course, continue having a fan-freaking-tastic time. And if there's anything specific else that you guys would like to see me check out that I maybe didn't give the love that it deserved, go ahead and let me know in that comment section down below. But that's going to start wrapping up for me for now. Best of luck to you guys and gals. Getting all of these new attachments and modding and making the best guns imaginable. Best of luck leveled up and breeding your puppas, getting the perks that you want, protecting your base, getting the chopper gas tank going, and joining the chopper squad and protecting your base, going out on raids, defeating the witch and all the other bosses, getting them bones, getting past the multiplayer wall a lot cheaper by the way right now, and most important of all, having yourselves an absolute fan for fantastic time all throughout. But that's gonna go ahead and do it for me. Thank you guys a whole ton for watching. Have yourselves an awesome one, and I'll talk to you next one. See ya.